It's something swirling right fucking here, like in the middle of my fucking chest. It's, I don't know how to describe it. It's, I don't know what, how to interpret it neither. Is it love? Is it fear? Is it the pearl of great price that is crystallizing within myself that I accepted and brought? Is it my insecurities? Is it my coming into conscious realization of who God is? And I don't know, but a few times in my life I have felt something so fucking deeply, and it's certainly interesting. I'm not complaining. I like it. It's but it's really fucking intense. This is Ciprian G at the present and precise moment of 8:38 p.m. documenting step number 39 out of the book Steps to Knowledge, and yeah, let's do that. Step 39, it's called The Power of God is with me. It's a 230 minutes practice period step, and I've done it over 2 days, or you could say over 1 day and a half, because yesterday I did both practices, more than 30 minutes actually, like 40 minutes each, but I couldn't reach that stillness that it's required for the step. I couldn't still my mind and couldn't still my feelings, and I thought maybe I should give it another try today, because I feel it's a really important step. So I thought that, hey, I didn't work as I wanted it to work yesterday, maybe I give it another day, another try today, maybe it'll go better. But it didn't. I mean, it went decent, I guess. I did half a practice today. I said, you know, I did the practices yesterday. I don't know. Anyway, I wrote like just a fucking sentence, but I guess it, I'll try to explain it as well as I can, but I guess it does encompass the power of God, which is within me, and as well as everybody else, every other sentient being. So, the power of God is to give life to the dead, to call into existence the things that do not exist. And that's from Romans 4:17. And that's all I write. What does it mean for God to call the dead? I mean, wait a second. How is it put? To give life to the dead. What does that mean? Well, it's written for us, for like for humans, for we that are here. And dead to us, it's what is dead. It's something that it's not alive to us. Damn. And like, if I now imagine being in the open sea in my own yacht and having the fun of my life, my senses tell me that is not true. That is a dead thing. That it's not true. So God is able to revive the dead. That sees me in the middle of the on the ocean on my yacht. That is a dead thing to me right now, because I'm not aware of it. But to God, that is what he calls forth from the dead to be alive. And it's basically with everything, with feelings, with relationships, with every desire you have in this world. So that's the same as saying, call into existence the things that do not exist. I might now want a car, like really specifically a car that I know that I want so much, And well, I don't have it. It's not, it doesn't exist for me, that car. But to claim the power of God is to call into existence the things that do not exist. And as Neville Goddard puts it, the simplicity of it, God is imagination. But to, so that car which I want, or me in the middle of the ocean being on that fucking yacht, that's dead. That's not in existence right now. But to use the power of God is to be there in imagination, to act as I am actually in there, to call things that are not seen as seen, and the unseen becomes seen. That's the power of God. It's basically it's basically all imagination. Everything exists in our imagination, and to get that thing from the imagination to the physical world is to act in faith that it is already ours. So that's why faith, belief in God, is one of the most important things when you want anything in life, is to keep faith that which you have prayed for is yours already. It's not something that it's gonna be, it's something that it's already there. So yeah, a message. How do I feel about that? About a message? Well, these two past days, why I couldn't concentrate properly is because I'm feeling this big fucking void. I don't know if it's a void, I don't know if it's something, it's something swirling right fucking here, like in the middle of my fucking chest. It's, I don't know how to describe it. I don't know how to interpret it neither. Is it love? Is it fear? Is it the pearl of great price that is crystallizing within myself that I accepted and brought? Is it my insecurities? Is it my coming into conscious realization of who God is? And I don't know, but and a few times in my life I have felt something so fucking deeply, and it's certainly interesting. I'm not complaining. I like it. It's really fucking intense. It's like my whole attention is centered there, and but I guess, yeah, this is what I had to say about the power of God that is with me and within you as well. It's basically imagination, but to see that thing in imagination and not act upon it as though as it's already yours is to not have faith, and without faith nothing is created. I think it is said that God created the world with faith or something along those lines. I still need to get a proper reading of the Bible, but yeah, I guess this is it for now, for step number 39. tough times indeed. I don't know, it's interesting. It's really fucking interesting. There's a lot to learn for me, and yeah, I like it. I enjoy it. I try to. But anyway, this has been Ciprian G documenting step number 39 out of the book Steps to Knowledge. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate that. And see you next time. Ciprian G is out, baby. Bam.